pigeon. Hey everyone, I'm back with another video. Now I know that I mentioned in the last time that today's video would be about editing, but I've noticed something special about the sunrise and the sunsets over the past few weeks. And I felt that while Singapore was still under the circuit breaker lockdown period, I should make a quick video just to talk about air pollution and how it affects the quality of a sunrise or a sunset. So here's the thing. Since the 5th of May, I've challenged myself to wake up early to photograph the sunrise right here from home for 30 days in a row. Now I've noticed that there seemed to be a much higher frequency of having a very dramatic, radiant and colourful sunrise since we've entered this lockdown period. Now I've long considered Singapore to be one of the hardest places to get a colourful and radiant sunrise or sunset as compared to other countries that are not as close to the equator as we are. Now there's a few factors that determine the quality of a sunrise or sunset, and for this video, I'm just going to be talking about two of these factors, cloud cover and air quality. Now on the 6th of May 2020, our local newspaper, The Straits Times, states that the National Environmental Agency has said that our daily pollutant levels are within the World Health Organization air quality guidelines. Now Singapore has been unable to meet these guidelines for quite a while. So I have here with me one of my favourite landscape photography books. This is The Art, Science and Craft of Great Landscape Photography by Mr. Glenn Randall. And he says here that the darkness of a blue sky is a good barometer of the cleanliness of the atmosphere and the probability of warm light during sunrise or sunset. He also says that the presence of larger particles, this means pollution, also means that the warm colours of a sunrise or sunset will be diluted. So what this means for us is that right now with the clean air in Singapore, it's actually the best time to shoot sunset or sunrise. But please don't break the law if you're not allowed to go out and shoot. Please don't go out and shoot. Shoot from your home if you can, if you have a window that's facing east or facing west. I know that composition and framing could be a challenge when you're shooting out of a window, but let's just work with what we have right now. Now, another indicator of a great sunrise or sunset is cloud cover. In general, I found that having high altitude clouds, it does a marvelous job of catching the light and scattering it into many beautiful radiant colors. On the other hand, low altitude clouds that tend to block the light and your skies become muted and muddy, which is fine if that's the effect that you're going for. Now, unfortunately, here in Singapore, there's often far too much cloud cover. But what we can do is to look for a weather app or a weather forecast website that shows you the cloud cover forecast in terms of altitude. Now personally, I like high altitude clouds of around 30 to 60% coverage and as little low altitude clouds as possible to give me the best results. So that's it for today's video on air quality for sunrise and sunsets. I hope this has been useful for you. I'm very excited to show you guys the results of my 30-day challenge. So I'm giving you guys a sneak preview of the first 10 sunrises that I've took. Thank you guys for watching the video. Give me a thumbs up. Remember to leave your comments down below. Smash that subscribe button. Shalom and goodbye.